Welcome back.
So be discreet.
I'm here. I'll handle this.
Russians pay homage to Alexandros. Kabor's tower to a dull blue green, grime and dust coat the surface, examine it. Okay, it's an offering bowl. It would have been. Okay,
indeed. I'll take care
of this. Poor fools. They were unprepared for this.
I'm here.
How? Of course.
Tread
cautiously.
How may I help?
No mercy.
Yeah.
Yes? Yeah!
If we do this like that.
Feels like poison.
Feels like poison.
Here. Of course.
Oh!
Yes?
How may I help?
Feels like poison.
Feels like poison.
What do you need?
I'm here. Certainly.
How may I help?
Okay. Moving, it's moving. Miss.
What do you need?
With relish.
Ooh!
Aye? Hey.
Oh, come on!
I'm here.
Dead. Nice.
Yes?
Lots of cuts inward, barring any further progress.
I'll handle this.
I shall deal with this one.
Yeah?
And you flanked. And we kill.
Yes?
I shall deal with this one.
Oh. No movement.
Oh.
They'll fall by my hand.
Oh. Oh no. No, 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 no. Okay.
What do you need? How may I help?
The conjunction casts fingers to the nearest enemy, and then to the next nearest. Will-o-wisp. I'm at half HP.
Certainly.
Oh. Yeah.
Damn it. Okay. Okay. Boom, and then can't do any more.
No mercy.
Okay.
Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. Doing good. We're doing good. Sure, this is working out. Boom.
Leave it to me.
Stands up and attacks. Ooh, some big hits. Attack.
Sadly, I cannot.
How may I help?
No mercy.
Okay. You're flanked, bitch.
Yeah.
Hiya.
How may I help?
I'll take care of this.
That's Odorisi.
Frozen mid-stride, this grand figure is turned toward the colossal pillar of Azure that dominates the chamber. The ashen corpse outstretched hand rests upon the crystal dulled surface. Clutched tightly in its remnants of a fist is a bundle of papers bound together by a leather cord. Several more papers are scattered on the ground at your feet.
Think that's the guy we're looking for? Sure holding on to those papers tight.
As you pull the papers free, the ashen figure is gripping them, sloth away, disintegrating into a plume of dust. You have gained the quest item, the notes. As these notes acquired from corpse returns a collection of jargon diagrams, they loot mechanical and chemical processes used to treat Adra while it is refined into powder. These notes would doubtless be of interest to those working. Okay. Yeah, just put to your stash. Standing here by the lone tree, you are struck with a feeling of dread. The air around you, the very motes of ash and dust, all of it is stagnant and still. The feeling grows worse when you look up at the Adra and sense no energy flowing into its surface. It is, though it's been disconnected from the wheel.
You place your hand against the pillar of luminous Adra. A dim, warm light emanates from the surface, but it feels cool to the touch. Pinpricks dance along your fingers, uncomfortable, but not painful. A woman's voice, scratchy, distant, and halting, echoes in your mind.
Ashley's back. Yay.
Find your soul in him.
Huh.
You concentrate, peering into the Adra's energy as you would peer into a soul. Its inner light is blinding, but as you become accustomed to it, you perceive the core of the Adra itself, a churning mass of millions of soul fragments. With a jolt, the energy reaches out to you. The Angwithin ruin fragments around you, breaking into incoherent shapes and dissolving to dust, falling into an infinite well of dark gray vapor. Even the ground itself disintegrates into nothingness. All that remains is the murky expanse of the in-between. The Adra pillar, and a skein of golden threads rooted in the pillar that extend far off into the distance.
What's the in-between? Is that the... Right. Okay. Yep. Gotcha. Where we were before.
You focus on the threads. You catch glimpses of memories, your memories, mingled among the memories of thousands of other captive souls. The filaments begin to cohere, rapidly twining into a golden cord. With a muffled crack, the cord ripples outward in a violent wave toward the endless distance. The cord undulates over a space so vast that you lose sight of the wave before it finds its end. Then, a heavy creaking, like the sound of mountains shearing under their own weight, washes through the dull gloom of the in-between. A violent force yanks you along the cord at an incredible speed. The murk of the in-between warps erratically, as though you are observing it through an ill-ground lens. Just as quickly as you were pulled forward, you stop. Suspended below a massive figure of ancient carved Adra. Like all Adra, it glimmers with energy, but the souls and memories within it are not flowing down. They churn in a vortex that burns at the heart of the statue's mass in some invisible engine. It is Aethys.
No!
The great golden cord terminates in his back, sending pulses of energy throughout his limbs as they move. He walks in long, slow strides toward a brilliant pillar of Adra far in the distance. It shines even more brightly in the in-between than Aethys.
Ooh.
From within the teeming throng of souls, dozens of eyes look out to you. Through the cord, their collective anguish and despair push at the edge of your mind.
Help us! Please! Help us!
Their voices echo in your mind. Somewhere within their ranks, you can feel the presence of your own soul slumbering deeper in the gyre.
Reach out to the lost souls, push past to find my own. Ooh, the choices. We're telling it to stop. I think one is the Paladin way. Lose part of my soul? I'm gonna be selfish here. Let's find my own. Because there was that thing, find your soul.
You attempt to evade the lost souls and find yourself within Aethys. But the incredible power flowing through the gods' body repulses you. Not even your Watcher powers can penetrate the massive tides of energy crashing through him. The souls sense your presence and continue to desperately cry out to you. Aethys' stride slows and stops. His head slowly pivots until its great burning eyes are cast back along the cord. As his gaze meets yours, you feel an overwhelming rush of incredible joy mingled with profound sadness. You have sensed similar anguish in lost souls, but never with this intensity. A soothing voice drifts into your mind.
Ooh.
It takes great bravery to venture through the in-between, even for a Watcher.
A swell of admiration radiates out from the god's heart, a force so intense that it momentarily overwhelms you.
You do not need to follow me, for their sake or your own. Something beautiful is coming. Something that will save us all.
A great light shines from Aethys' brow. So bright that even the souls within him flinch from the source, cowering in fear. Through the glare, you see Aethys' massive arm reach up to grasp the golden cord. The tether carrying energy from the Audra pillar to him that also suspends your consciousness.
One, two, or three, wait.
Time cannot stop for any of us, Watcher. Even me.
Ooh.
Aethys yanks on the golden cord, pulling it from his back. The cord tears into filaments that blacken and dissolve to dust. Without pause, he turns to resume his stride toward the distant pillar of Audra, shining on the boundless horizon. You hear the souls within him cry out for just a moment, before your consciousness is snapped away from them. The in-between goes dark. For a second, you feel a mix of nausea and a sensation like spinning and falling. Then the moment ends. Your consciousness has returned to the Angwithin arena. The world is sideways, the Audra pillar upside down. You flinch at the feeling that you're standing on the ceiling. The disorientation overwhelms you, and you collapse to your knees next to the luminous Audra pillar. Previously dim and flickering, the pillar now glows with a strong and steady light. You touch the Audra again, but the chill and prickling sensations you felt before are gone, replaced with a comforting warmth, like the embers of a fire that has just lost its flame.
Oh. You return your free a hand on your back.
You alright? Come on, we just got you back.
I'm fine.
I heard you say that before. Had something to do with a 2,000-year-old lunatic talking to you in your dreams. I've seen you commune with souls of the dead, but this looked altogether different. What happened? Already? Moving things along rather quickly this time, aren't we? Don't suppose he told you what he's up to, did he? Or at least where he's going?
I saw Mullins in his path, but he told me not to follow that something beautiful was coming.
He said the same thing to people in Rayet Saris 20 years ago.
That's where they killed him. That's right.
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Yes?
They'll fall by my hand.
Hey.
Yes?
Get the flank bonus. Oh.
Yes?
They'll fall by my hand.
Hmm?
Killed the imp.
How may I help?
Isolate within the last borders of its super cannon. Huh. Mars and Grime have been scrapped clear. Blood watch for this mirror, revealing the vibrant hues of what? Of Ingrid and figures beneath. Turn a reckless defeat of 7 beast behead.
May I help?
I shall deal with this one.
Yeah?
Come on!
The hell is that? Nice. What's next? That one. Okay.
Aye.
Lavaru beyond seek. Behind me.
What's that do? Fire and focus getting into that.
Yes.
To me. Sorry, friend. I can't.
Any grazing? Gets up and hits. Oh, nice.
Yes?
step back a bit, and now you can shoot from a distance. Okay, we lay on hands.
I'm here.
Hi.
Nice hit.
Yes, certainly.
What do you need?
Hi. Yeah.
Boom.
How may I help?
Ooh, level ups.
I'll take care of it.
We put one into I'm gonna put one in mechanics. And then another one into religion, and then we get a new. Already got those, so no. We'll do that. Then we get a new weapon proficiency. Let's grab large shield. Just in case we decide to increase his shield, like, so we have more shield options. I'm not so worried about weapon options. They're not much of an issue. If I add another one to mechanics, then yeah, we'll go one with mechanics, and then we'll go one in an intimidate. So we're like, into the fray? If he's distance away, he can go, whee! So he's got Saber. We'll give him the option of a normal half sword. Ooh, I like the idea of parrying blade though. When he's using daggers. But he's a fighter. Maybe the staff. That's a club. Bordering blows. Yeah. Could work. Wow, okay.
Well, don't see why not.
Yes?
Let's do it.
Onward!
Oh.
With relish.
I fucked up there.
What do you need?
May I be a candle in the night?
Good hit. Oh, nice. I can do that again.
I hope nobody saw that. How may I help?
So if I move over here.
Afford another loss.
I lava will be on thick.
Hey, leave it to me.
Okay, what's this? I'm sure about the constructs first, the new techniques. Okay. Well, might as well just grab them.
Well, as long as I don't get caught. Of course.
Difficulty 4. Level aim up. We'll do one into Arcana. And then we do one into history. Metaphysics. Ooh, metaphysics, actually. We get a new wizard spell. We're gonna go for a tier 2 spell. Oh, I like that. And weapon proficiency. So he's got a scepter, so we'll go for that. Right? Yeah. Okay. Hey. Okay.
Well, after you.
What could it be? I knew the bold and reckless and the fortunate may pass safely. One, two, three. No. One. two, three. Ooh. Inventory. Weapons. You now have a proficiency of swords, right? I did give him that. No, I gave him clubs. But the sword could be better. Maybe the sword will be better on my guy because we give him the best stuff. Yeah. Enchanting. So we get to can enchant it. Oh. Injuries. Well, we don't think anyone has injuries yet. Plus one to penetration, and we can do it. Success. Okay, you wear light armor.
Yeah, well, don't see why not.
I'll have this. Yeah, some Opalov sister, Gift of the Stone. We've discovered everything. To the dig site. Ooh. I just looked over at the recording software. 37 minutes. Oh! Got too into this. I don't think we'll ever be back here, so I want to keep going through all the different doors here and all that stuff. Oh, as the souls move past you, some turn their heads in your direction, but most seem fixated below you, on the edge beneath your feet. You nod their heads in thanks, or raise a hand to acknowledge your presence.
You're doing it again. That look, like you couldn't beat a Hollowborn in a personality contest. You want to share what you're seeing, or do I got a guess?
Souls, dozens of them, maybe hundreds, they're all going to the Atropilla.
What do you suppose that's about? Maybe they got food in there.
Around you, one of them is standing a bit closer than the others and gestures for your attention.
Watcher, we'd like to come with you. You have our thanks. We appreciate that you showed us the way to the Audra. But what if it goes dark before we reach the beyond?
Hmm.
Thank you, Watcher.
Spooky. Alright. Pause the game. This will be the end of this episode, so I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, subscribe and smell the notification bell to keep up to date. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.